हरिओम फ्रेंड्स, जय श्री कृष्णा, जय द्वारकाधीश। वेलकम टू सनातन दुनिया, योर स्पिरिचुअल होम। इन दिस वीडियो आई शैल बी गिविंग अ ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट द फेमस द्वारकाधीश टेम्पल इन द्वारका, गुजरात, इंडिया। द द्वारकाधीश टेम्पल, ऑल्सो नोन एज द जगत मंदिर, इज अ हिंदू टेम्पल डेडिकेटेड टू लॉर्ड कृष्णा, हु इज वर्शिप्ड हियर बाय द नेम द्वारकाधीश और किंग ऑफ द्वारका। The temple is located at Dwarka city of Gujarat, India, which is one of the destinations of Char Dham, a Hindu pilgrimage circuit. The main shrine of the five-story building supported by 72 pillars is known as Jagat Mandir or Nija Mandir. Archaeological findings suggest it to be 2000 to 2200 years old. The temple was enlarged in the 15th or 16th century. The Dwarkadish temple is a Pushti Marg temple, hence it follows the guidelines and rituals created by Vallabhacharya and Vitthaleshnath. According to tradition, the original temple was believed to have been built by Krishna's grandson Vajranabha over the Hari Griha, Krishna's residential place. The original structure was destroyed by Mahmud Begada in 1472 and subsequently rebuilt in the 15th or 16th century. The temple became part of the Char Dham pilgrimage considered sacred by Hindus in India. Adi Shankaracharya, the 5th century Hindu theologian and philosopher, visited the shrine. The other three being comprising Rameshwaram, Badrinath and Puri. Even today, a memorial within the temple is dedicated to his visit. Dwarkadish is the 90th Divya Desham of Vishnu on the subcontinent, glorified in the Divya Prabandha sacred texts. It was rebuilt by Raja Jagat Singh Rathore. The temple is at an elevation of 12.19 meters, 40 feet above mean sea level. It faces west. The temple layout consists of a Garbha Griha, Nija Mandira or Hari Griha, and an Antarala, an antechamber. It is conjectured that this temple location is 2500 years old, where Krishna had built his city and a temple. However, the existing temple is dated to the 16th century. Now for some information on the legend surrounding this temple. As per Hindu legend, Dwarka was built on a piece of land by Krishna that was reclaimed from the sea. Sage Durvasa once visited Krishna and his wife Rukmini. The sage wished that the pair took him to their palace. The pair readily agreed and started walking with the sage to their palace. After some distance, Rukmini got tired and she requested some water from Krishna. Krishna dug a mythical hole that brought in river Ganga to the place. Sage Durvasa was furious and cursed Rukmini to remain in the place. The temple where Rukmini's shrine is found is believed to be the place where she stood. Now for some information on how Lord Krishna became Dwarkadish or how he came to be known as Dwarkadish. The story of how Shri Krishna became famous as Dwarkadish is very interesting and also a benchmark to the rulers. Though he was the king, he ruled democratically. Jarasandha, father-in-law of Kansa, attacked Mathura on 17 different occasions, and on each occasion, under the leadership of Shri Krishna, the people of Mathura bravely repulsed the attack. Krishna realized that the real strength of Jarasandha was his reliance on Hans and Dhimak, who were on Jarasandha's side. So, with a great deal of foresight, Shri Krishna cleverly got Hans and Dhimak killed. This was the policy of war. Shri Krishna had to fight the large majority of people who were materialistic and evil-minded. Jarasandha was frightened after the death of Hans and Dhimak, and his army lost confidence. Jarasandha, with great efforts, once again built up his army and invaded Mathura for the 18th time. On this occasion, Bikadru, a member of the Yadav assembly, spoke the bitter truth. He said, Krishna, we have limitless love for you. We cannot compensate for your obligations on us. Yet these invasions are because of you. The civic life of Mathura is completely disrupted. Commerce and trade have been ruined. The people are not able to attend to agricultural duties, and as a result, the progress is hindered. And on top of it all, the danger of one more invasion of Jarasandha is hanging over Mathura. Hence, in these circumstances, for the good of the people, I request you to leave us. It is bitter, but it is the truth. Please consider, Shri Krishna, your followers are not sentimental. They cannot remain sentimental because of your teaching. Therefore, I, as your devotee, tell you the truth without fear. The entire assembly was stunned and silent. Shri Krishna's father Vasudev supported Vikrendu in assembly. Shri Krishna realized that the republic had to face many dangers because of him, and he decided to leave Mathura. Thus, he proved that he not only advised but also lived accordingly. He advised Yadavas, I have taught you true culture. Live according to the ideals and impart these teachings to others. I will leave Mathura and go to Dwarka in Saurashtra. Thereafter, Shri Krishna crossed Gomantak River, Gomantak Girinar Mountain, and went to Saurashtra, where he built Dwarka city, city of gold, at a distance of 20 miles from Prabhaspatan, to raise Somnath. Shri Krishna appeared to have settled in Dwarka, though his mind was engaged in re-establishing a kingdom based on principles of true religion. This was his life's goal, and he made Dwarka, the empire which is based on the principle of true religion, called Dharma Rajya, in true sense, where he became known as the ruler of Dwarka, Sri Dwarkadish. The importance of Shri Krishna's life and teaching was not limited to his contemporary period, but is equally so to the posterity. This is why his birthday is remembered and celebrated today, even after 5,000 years. Not only Vaishnavas, followers of Vishnu and Shri Krishna, but also all those who are interested in his philosophy celebrate his birthday with great devotion. The philosophy of his life has stood the test of time. Now for some further information regarding this temple. Since this site is associated with the ancient city of Dwarka and the Vedic era Krishna of Mahabharata, it is an important place of pilgrimage for Hindus. It is one of the three main pilgrimage sites related to Krishna circuit, namely 48th course Parikrama of Kurukshetra in Haryana state, Braj Parikrama in Mathura of Uttar Pradesh state, and Dwarka Parikrama, Dwarkadish Yatra at Dwarkadish temple in Gujarat state. The flag atop the temple shows the sun and moon, which is believed to indicate that Krishna would be there till the sun and moon exist on earth. The flag is changed up to 5 times a day, but the symbol remains the same. The temple has a 5-story structure built on 72 pillars. The temple spire is 78.3 meters high. The temple is constructed of limestone, which is still in pristine condition. The temple shows intricate sculptural detailing done by successions of dynasties that ruled the region. The structure was not expanded much by these works. There are 2 entrances to the temple. The main entrance, north entrance, is called Moksha Dwara, door to salvation. This entrance takes one to the main market. The south entrance is called Swarga Dwara, gate to heaven. Outside this doorway are 56 steps that leads to the Gomati River. The temple is open from 6 a.m. to 1 p.m. and 5 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. The Krishna Janmashtami festival or Gokula Ashtami, the birthday of Krishna, was commissioned by Vallabha in 1473, who lived from 1473 to 1531. According to a legend, Mirabai, the famed Rajput princess who was also a poetess saint and a staunch devotee of Krishna, merged with the deity at this temple. It is one of the Saptapuri, the seven holy cities of India. The temple is also the location of Dwarka Pitha, one of the four Peeths, religious centers established by Adi Shankaracharya, who pioneered unification of Hindu religious beliefs in the country. It is a four-story structure representing four Peeths established by Adi Shankaracharya in different parts of the country. There are paintings on the walls here depicting the life history of Shankaracharya, while the dome has carvings of Shiva in different postures. Now for some information on how to reach Dwarkadish temple in Dwarka, Gujarat. By air, the closest airports to Dwarka are Porbandar, which is located about 95 kilometers away from the temple, and Jamnagar, which is located about 145 kilometers away from the temple. By train, the nearest rail junction is the Dwarka railway station, that is 2.1 kilometers distance from the main city, and it is going to take hardly 5 minutes to reach using an auto or taxi. By road, bus packages can be booked by state and private bus service providers that connect Dwarka to the major cities of Gujarat. So friends, here ends this short video on the Dwarkadish temple in Dwarka, Gujarat, India. I pray to Lord Vishnu and Lord Krishna that all people should get the opportunity to visit this temple at least once in their lives, if not more times. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day ahead. Hari Om, Jai Shri Krishna, Jai Dwarkadish.